How does the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania tax retirees? Now, this is exciting. Well, let's dive right into it and find out. That way you can know for sure whether or not retiring in Pennsylvania is worth it or if you should look elsewhere. Welcome again, my friends, to the Heritage Wealth Planning YouTube channel. This is the channel where you learn about Pennsylvania taxes for retirees. Maybe one of these days we'll do a list for non-retirees as well. But for right now, just retirees. And we talk about all the other 49 states in the union, plus everything else financial planning related, estate planning, social security maximization strategies, how to reduce your taxes in retirement, everything under the sun financial planning. You've come to the right place. So if you like what we hear, what we talk about here, by all means, click on that red little button right there to subscribe and then the little bell to be notified of future content as well. Try to do about 5 videos a week. Sometimes I do more, but I try to do 5 weeks. So I'll be giving you further content that you need to be aware of to make sure your financial planning situation is as squared away as possible. All right, so let's dive right into it about the Commonwealth of PA. I used to work in Philadelphia, and so I had to pay the Philadelphia wage tax, and I commuted right over the Delaware River there to New Jersey. I've always been a fan of Pennsylvania, actually. It's always been a nice place. That's where Norman Rockwell, apparently, when he did all those pictures of the kids on Thanksgiving and whatnot, is based on Pennsylvania. So Pennsylvania is a great state, and so far, so good. Again, wow. Wow. Pennsylvania gets a dark green, according to Kiplinger's, which if eyes don't deceive me, says mostly tax friendly for retirees. That's fantastic. So let's take a gander and see why PA is one of the most favorable for retirees when it comes to a tax planning. I'm actually stunned by that. I didn't think it'd be horrific, but that's fantastic. So Keystone State shows its Quaker roots and extends a friendly hand. The guys at Kiplinger, man, these guys always have these little quips that are funny. It is one of the most generous states in the nation when it comes to offering income tax exclusions on a wide variety of retirement income. Fantastic. Way to go. Pennsylvania does not tax Social Security benefits or any Pennsylvania public or private pension plan. Doesn't nick distributions from 401ks, IRAs, deferred comp, or other retirement accounts as well. But property taxes can be steep in some communities, though. The sales tax is 6%. But food, clothing, textbook, heating, fuels, and prescription and non-prescription drugs are exempt. It does have a local sales tax on addition of does have a local sales tax of an additional 2%. Excuse me, in Allegheny County, where Pittsburgh has another local sales tax of 1% as well, bringing the population weighted average to 6.34, which is pretty doggone cheap, actually. Has a flat income tax rate of 3.07, which is quite good. Social Security benefits are not taxed. IRAs are not taxed. Pensions, public, wow. So for retirement income after 59 and a half is not taxed either. Distributions aren't taxed from eligible retirement plan accounts, including what we just talked about. That's fantastic. Property taxes. So this is where they get you. The median home value in PA is 165, and the property tax, the median is 2559. Again, median just means half above and half below. What's that, about one? That's not one, quite one and a half or so. I guess 1.35 or something like that. Let's see if they have a homestead exemption. Homeowners and renters 65 and older who lived on incomes, a maximum standard rebate of $650. Is available through this property tax rent rebate program. To qualify, the annual household income must not exceed $35,000. 50% of Social Security payments and 50% of railroad payment benefits are excluded from this eligibility income. Okay, well, that's pretty good. So if you make $50,000 Social Security and $10,000 in retirement income, $25,000 plus the $10,000 right there, and you're going to get a reduction on your property tax. Just more reason why Social Security planning and Roth IRAs are so critical, my friends. Sales taxes due on purchases of vehicles. Pennsylvania did have a pretty significant inheritance tax. I remember that when I was working there. Inheritance tax is calculated on a percentage of the value of the estate transferred to beneficiaries. The amount is determined based on the relationship of the heir to the decedent. I remember that. The tax rate is 4.5% for direct decedents, lineal heirs, so if it goes downwards. Kids, grandkids, 4.5% on the inheritance tax, 12% for going sideways. So 12% for if you're, you know, nieces, nephews, brothers, sisters, whatnot, and 15% for other heirs. So that's where they get you, the inheritance tax. Now, if you die, you can leave it to your spouse. It doesn't cost anything. But if you leave it to your kids and, you know, grandkids, and then going sideways, your brother, sister, and whatnot, it's going to be pretty painful. Property a husband and wife own jointly is exempt from the tax, and so is property inherited from a spouse or a child 21 years or younger. The inheritance tax for farming families was eliminated in 2012. That's good. If the inheritance tax is paid within 3 months of the decedent's death, a 5% discount may apply. That's a pretty big deal. That's noteworthy, because there is no, at least when I was up there, and I don't see it here, there's no exemption either. Like right now in Massachusetts, you get $1 million exemption. That's for an estate tax. In New Jersey, it used to be $675,000. That just meant the first $675,000 of your estate transfers tax-free. Not hard to get $675,000 or $1 million when you factor in life insurance, 401ks, and your home. But if I recall, Pennsylvania, it's from the first dollar. So that's bad. But we'll talk about that. All right. So let's go to see what Tax Foundation says. 3.07 individual income tax rate in PA. The state and local tax burden is 10.2, which puts them in the top 15th, which is a burden without question. Now, Tax Foundation, though, they're not talking solely for they're just talking total tax burden for everybody. They're not talking about retirees, and that's what we're focused on here today. And so retirees, 3.07 is more what we're talking about. Tax Freedom Day is 23rd, which puts them at rank 32 for the overall tax friendliness, which means it's on the low end, which is too bad. But again, for retirees, it's completely different. Sales tax is pretty low, 6% on the state, which looks like it's going to be high at 16. But you factor in the average local is only 0.34, and your total sales tax is 6.34, which ranks pretty high in terms of tax favorability. They tax it pretty, tax pretty high on cigarettes. But look at that. The number one gas tax in the union, number one, they tax it 58.7 cents on the gallon. I just chuckle because New Jersey is notorious for being a high tax state. When New Jersey price of gas back then was 10 times cheaper than PA. Never. So I'd go back and forth. I'd always get gas in New Jersey because it was cheaper. Unfortunately, I had to have someone pump it for you, which is always kind of a pain. When it's cold, it's actually nice, but I remember that gas tax in PA was horrific. And there it is, number one in the union. That's pretty high. On a side note, South Carolina is a heck of a lot cheaper than Georgia, by the way. So if you're right there on the Georgia-South Carolina line, just wait till you get to South Carolina. It's a whole lot cheaper than coming to Georgia. All right, so property tax, yeah, okay, there you go. About 1.5 in Pennsylvania, which puts them in the top 12th. But because their average property isn't as high as the average for the United States, the actual dollars that the folks in Harrisburg collect are less than what the actual percentage is. So, I mean, it's still 1.48 is 1.48, regardless of the price of your home or the fair market value. It's still in the high end. So let's go to smart assets. So Tax Foundation and Kiplinger's does kind of compete a little bit here, because Tax Foundation is looking at the overall tax circumstance for PA. What I was looking at Kiplinger's is mostly for retirees. So let's look at what Smart Assets says. Yeah, they say it's tax friendly there as well. So that does not shock me. So what we're going to do, we're just going to go right into it and say $50,000 of retirement Social Security income. And then we're going to go $50,000 of IRA income. Married, filing jointly, born in 1963, and you pay nothing. Nothing in income tax. Look at that, my friends. Nothing. Because they don't tax IRA income. They don't tax Social Security income. Can't beat that. But again, it's not a tax-free state. So all these people say, I'm going to live in a tax-free state. You got to understand what else is in there, my friends. Okay, so look at that. Now, on that same income, you're paying $12,000 to Uncle Sam. All right, so you're getting hammered from Uncle Sam, but you're not paying anything to the state, which is good. Tax-friendly towards retirees. Social Security is not taxed. Retirement income withdrawals are not taxed. Wages are taxed at normal rate. But remember, if you're working, it's only 3%, so that's not so shabby. Pensions aren't taxed. Well, the Northeast is generally considered a poor region for retirement because of high cost of living and expensive taxes. PA is an exception. And I might add Delaware too, my friends. Property taxes in Delaware are way low. And I can't remember the income tax off the top of my head, but if I'm not mistaken, it's pretty doggone tax friendly too. So, retirement taxes in PA are also low. Pennsylvania is, here we go. Sales taxes. What I want to talk about. The state fully exempts all income from Social Security and retirement accounts. We talked about that. Whilst property taxes are somewhat higher than the average total sales tax, 6.34, is among the lowest in the union, among the top 20 lowest, I should say. All right, so Social Security, no, we talked about that. How high are property taxes in PA? Fairly high. The effective rate is about over 1.5, which ranks at the 13th highest in the union. Some of the highest states are found, the highest rates in the state are found in the Pittsburgh area. Allegheny County has an average about 2%. Wow. However, there are property tax relief programs, as we talked about before, but you got to qualify. It's going to be tough because you can only have, was it, $35,000 of income. And again, half of your Social Security will be excluded from that, which is good. But, you know, still, that's not a huge amount of money to earn, but to get the before you lose out on those exemptions. I just want to see a homestead. Pennsylvania's most all that. Yeah, right there. An income no greater than $35,000 if they own their own home. Yes, yeah, we talked about. Well, this is where Social Security retirement benefits. Okay. The income includes 50% of Social Security retirement. Okay, so they're taking half of Social Security and any other income you have from another source. Okay. Yeah, so and sales tax are pretty low. So, and the inheritance tax right here. The inheritance tax varies on the relationship to the inheritor to the decedent. 4.5% to as children or grandkids, 12% for siblings, and 15% for everybody else. So we're going to do another topic, a playlist on inheritance and estate taxes, and that would be something to consider. I'll dive into that a whole lot deeper in a different playlist. I'm not done with a state-by-state for retirees yet, but that is something you got to understand. In PA, inheritance taxes is a big deal, so we got to take that into consideration. But by and large, PA is fantastic. Pretty low sales tax, moderately high property tax, but not significant, especially when you factor in the cost of your home in PA is probably going to be on the lower end relative to some other states like New Jersey, New York, or whatnot. South Jersey, not so much, but a lot of other states, Massachusetts, what have you. But income taxes are essentially non-existent. You know, for anyone making $100,000 or less, if it's all in Social Security and all retirement income, you pay nothing. You just can't beat that. So if you find this helpful, again, subscribe right there. Comments are always welcome, my friends. Comments, subscribe, hit the little bell to be notified of future content. And again, I don't have boots on the ground. I have experience, but here in Georgia, you may be retired. You may be thinking about retirement, or you may have fled or gone to the state, whatever. I'd like to hear what your comments are. Share them with the audience. I mean, we get lots of people view this. The more people that comment, the more you can help out the other viewers. So put your comments down below if you would. And don't forget to subscribe. But we'll see you next time at the Heritage Wealth Planning YouTube channel. Thanks, guys.